So we're going to do another two example problems. So on these problems, this problem I want you to make a U-sub. No, hopefully not. Why is it better? So there's basically two choices for you. One of them is e to the x in this problem. One of them is e to the x, and the other one is x squared. Why is x squared a much better choice? Because the derivative gets better. Whereas e to the x derivative stays the same, doesn't get any better. So go with that choice. What does that leave for dv?
Ex
dx. The good news is the antiderivative doesn't get any worse. So that's the key right there. Antiderivative is just e to the x. All right, so go ahead and make those. You got to find du and regular v. And you might need to look up that formula again. I could fit it on the screen if I rewrite it. So I got the integration by parts formula on the board there. So are there any questions getting to here?
Does it matter if you do the U or the V? Like, du, is it a V?
We just made a choice to use V and U. I could use A and B if I wanted to. Right. Although usually letters like A, B, and C we think of as constants generally. So it wouldn't necessarily be the best to say like x squared equals A. That would kind of imply x squared is probably constant. Which it's not. So U and V are the two standard substitution letters we use in calculus generally.
Just since they look so similar.
So yeah, you need to make sure your V doesn't look like your U the way I do it. I don't use a sharp point on my V. I just put a little foot or whatever you call that part of the U right there to distinguish my U from my V. So make sure U doesn't look like V. Or you could have some problems.
That means you're getting if A is U's and V is then your SOL.
Yeah, your A might look like your U, depending on how you write your A. All right. How do we integrate this last remaining piece here? I'll zoom way in on it. So this is really what I need to integrate. It's painfully large. How in the world do we integrate this? It's a good try. So if I go with x, that's not going to be a useful u sub. The other choice is e to the x. And how in the world, so if u is e to the x, du, e to the x dx. So that's not going to get rid of the other x.
Do we just do integration by parts again?
Integration by parts again. Let's do it.
Like a
what's that?
Not quite.
No, there's no limit here. It's not L'Hopital's rule territory. All right, so I'm not going to help you on this integration by parts. So I want you to pick the right u and dv. It should be pretty clear. It's almost like last time.
I feel like you're like U prime or something.
Time.
derivative.